Blackstone Publishing presents The Game of Worlds by Roger McBride Allen. This book is read by Alex Boyles. To V, M, J, B, A, and A, who were there already, and Rose and James, who came along after. 1. Hotwire. 1999 AD, Carrboro, North Carolina, USA, Earth. Adam O'Connor slid his hand through the grillwork under the hood of the car and found the hood release latch on the first try. He pulled, and the hood popped up an inch or two. He put his hands under the lip and lifted it to swing up and clear. He took the flashlight out of his jacket pocket, turned it on, and aimed the light into the engine compartment. It was, he knew, a 318 V8. The car, an ancient 1973 Dodge Dart, belonged to his math teacher, Mrs. Meredith. Half the kids in the car club had worked on it at one time or another. Adam had too, before the faculty advisor kicked him out of the club for pulling the potato-in-the-exhaust-pipe trick on a fellow student's car. Everyone had gone after him for that one, the club advisor, the guidance counselor, his parents. It didn't seem right for all the adults to gang up and cause so much ruckus over such a little thing. The potato trick hadn't caused that much damage. It wasn't fair. So Adam had decided to carry out a little bit of harmless revenge. He pulled the cherry bomb rig out of his other pocket and tried to balance the flashlight on top of the car's battery, but the light started to roll off, and he had to grab it before it dropped into the engine compartment. But he'd need both hands to hook up the cherry bomb. He should have thought about that before he headed out and rigged some way to steady the light, maybe with duct tape or something. That wasn't the only problem. Even with the flashlight, it was hard to see what he was doing. The tight beam cast harsh shadows and dazzled his eyes, making the darkness around the cone of light seem all the darker. And even though he had worked on this very car a half dozen times, he'd forgotten one of its most annoying quirks. The counterbalance springs that held the hood up were old and worn, and the hood didn't stay up properly. It tended to drift down slowly until it hung about a third of the way open. He should have brought a stick or a pole to prop it up. Instead, he was reduced to holding the hood open with one hand while he held the flashlight with the other so he could find the spot where he was going to clip the leads, a procedure that left him a couple of hands short for doing the job. He had thought it was going to be easy and fast. Pop the hood, hook alligator clips on electric leads he had rigged to the cherry bomb fuse there and there, and slam the hood. A quick retreat into the darkness, then sit back and watch the fun. He pointed the flashlight at his wristwatch. It was almost 9 p.m. The drama club's rehearsal was going to break up any minute. That was why he had chosen this particular evening for the prank. Mrs. Meredith was the drama club sponsor. Not only would she be here at school tonight, but so would all the drama club members. A prank needed an audience. It would do no good to set off a cherry bomb in Mrs. Meredith's car unless a bunch of kids saw it and set the school's hallways buzzing with the story the next day. But no one was going to be talking about it if he didn't get this thing hooked up before the rehearsal ended and Mrs. Meredith and the club members came out into the parking lot. The hood was drifting down again. Adam tried to get it to stay up by standing on the driver's side of the car and wedging his body under it, supporting its weight between his shoulders. A sharp corner of metal caught him at the base of his neck, pinching down painfully. At least that got one hand free so he could hook up the leads, but the angle was awkward. He was practically face down in the engine compartment. He had to crane his neck to see even part of what he was doing, and that seemed to make the piece of metal cut deeper into the back of his neck. Adam was starting to sweat in spite of the cool night air. He hadn't planned this one well.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.